So here's the circuit, and I want to explain all of the components. That is the NTE1 a transformer, and it has a primary and a secondary. The primary is connected to the input of the oscillator with the white wire, and the other end of the primary is connected to the resistor here, to 1 lead of the resistor, and from the resistor the other lead goes to the output, and that's the one circle. And the other circle is, when you look at the coil, there is one end of the coil is going to the secondary from the transformer, one wire of the secondary, the red wire, and the black wire of the secondary is going to the capacitor, 1 lead of the capacitor, and the other lead goes to the other lead of the coil. And that's the making up of the circuit, and the transformer is changing impedance for the oscillator, so that it works in the range of 800 Hz to 1.6 kHz. And again, I explain it here with the circuit that is mounted on the front plate. And because of the many components used, here are two resistors, one variable capacitor, then we have the transformer here, and the circuit board. And here, there's the witness well, the, I call that inductor, a coil. I will explain it here. The transformer is connected to the input of the circuit, and that is the primary circuit, primary loop of the transformer, and the secondary is here, the red and the black. But I stay here at the primary loop, and the yellow wire goes to the first resistor, and then it goes from the first resistor to the second resistor, and from that it goes to the output. I have clipped in here the oscilloscope for the measurement. That's the output. So there's one loop at the primary, and the second loop at the secondary, whereby the red from the secondary is connected to one end of the coil, and the other end of the coil is connected to one end of the capacitor. The other end of the capacitor is connected to the black of the secondary of the transformer. So there's another loop. And when you do that, the circuit resonates at 1200 Hz, but it's quite unstable, because the circuit itself has a grounding, but the components not. So I decided to connect that part here, wherein there's also a coil with two ends of wire, two leads, and one lead I connect to the ground. It is here, and the other lead I connect to one end of the capacitor, where it goes to the transformer. At that spot, I clip the other end of the coil in the rubbing plate. And when you do that, the circuit gets much more stable. What you get here is a sine wave, and you can control the frequency of it when you turn the variable capacitor. And now it's 875, and you can go faster, up to 1 megahertz. Now I will quickly introduce the device when it's assembled. The front plate is on top of the device, on the white part you have seen before, where the rubbing plate is implemented. The electronic parts are inside. A few wires go still out because this is a very provisional setup, only to show how you would use this device. And you need a sample. I used a blood sample of myself. Could be, of course, also of another person. And then you tune here with the variable capacitor for a stick reaction on the sample. And I already have done that, so it's set up. And then you go here on the two dials and you dial a rate for the system to work with. And an example would be 1141. That is for the muscles, the muscular system in the body. And I have often tensions from work when I come home, and then I set the rate, which is 1141. Here 11 on the left dial and 41 on the right dial. And then I let it work for 4 to 5 minutes, and I feel an effect from that. Often I let it work even longer, like an hour or so, because it has a very relaxing and calming effect on myself. Everyone has to check his own constitution and what is needed for a betterment or for a balancing of the condition. Just for a little demonstration, when you look at the oscilloscope, we have now 889 Hz with a steady sine wave.